Get ready to match the stars. Bert Convy. J.P. Morgan. Charles Nelson Reilly. Brett Somers. Richard Dawson. And Betty White as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 73. And here's the host of Match Game 73, Gene Rivers.
Hello there. Hey. Thank you. Okay. You have all the fun. I'm standing back there, and you're all having... Now, what did you do there that got such a big laugh? I didn't see that.
Nothing. I just showed my bare face on television. That's all I did.
Oh, really? I heard him laughing out there.
Bare face liar.
Listen, speaking of bare face, what do you do when you're not here doing this? You're a busy lady.
You know what I'm getting ready to do?
What are you getting ready to do?
I'm going to go to camp with Brett Somers Klugman, because she has a blouse like the one I wore the other day, and these are her pearls, and we're going to wear our hair alike, and we're going to go to camp.
And we're going to be lookalikes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Could you go now?
Good time to withdraw that question.
I think so.
I work with my animals.
You work with your animals. I know you do, and I think that's marvelous.
That's what I do on my time off.
You work with your animals, too, though.
No, yes, and they're all in the Navy.
All right. Well, you've heard from the zoo. Now let's hear. Let's meet our current champ. Here's Jeff Nichols.
Yeah!
Hey, Jeff. Jeff, you've won $100. You won game one. And as time expired last time, we were ready to have a go at this super match with you. Are you ready for that?
I'm ready.
Okay, we're going to do that right after we do this. This man has won one game. He's got $100 to his credit. But now is a big moment for him because we've got the super match. Are you ready for that?
Let's try it.
Okay, Jeff, we're going to try it. Let's begin by pointing out that we polled a studio audience and we got their best response to this. Bear blank. Bear blank. Now, the answer given most often by that audience is worth $500 if you can match it. The second most frequent response, $250. The third, $100. Whatever you win up here will be yours to keep. And then you can try for 10 times that amount. The celebrities are going to help you. You'll choose three celebrities, get their responses one at a time, and then you can pick one of theirs or use one of your own. So start choosing celebrities.
Betty White.
You choose Betty White to fill in that blank.
Trust
bare
me,
blank.
Jeff. Trust me. Bare feet.
Bare feet is her response. All right, another celebrity, Jeff.
Brett.
Well, I wouldn't say, I guess I'd better not. What? How about if we go for bare back?
Bare back. Would you like to do nine choruses? Okay, so you've got bare feet and bare back. One more, Jeff.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Well, bare chest.
Bare chest. Okay, Charles says bare chest. So your celebrities
terrible.
Have given you bare feet, bare back, bare chest. Now you may choose one of those or come up with one of your own if you'd like. But now it's time to make a decision, Jeff.
Betty White says I should go with her. I'll go with bare feet.
You do anything Betty White tells you to do.
Oh, boy. Loves dogs. It's got to be wonderful.
That's true. Betty White is a wonderful person. I absolutely agree with you. All right.
Too bad she couldn't be here tonight.
We are looking for bare feet. Does that sound right? Yeah, I guess so. We are looking for the answer, bare feet. May we see the $100 response? Bare bottom. You almost said that, Brett.
Yeah.
So she said bare back. All right. Still looking for bare feet. May we see the $250 response? Bare back.
I told you
Brett.
To hang in with me, honey.
Yes, right. All right, Brett, give you that one. Here's your third and last chance, Jeff Nichols. Looking for bare feet. May we see the $500 response? Bare foot.
$1,000, $500 a foot.
That's right. And look at Charles Nelson Reilly. He never wears socks, and they've been kidding him about that all week. All right, so you've got it up there. You've won the $500. Oh, yes, and now you're going to have a chance at 10 times that amount or $5,000. You ready for that, Jeff?
Ready as I'll ever be.
You're a very happy guy, aren't you?
Oh, it's a great life.
That's good. I'm glad to hear you say that. Now, you're going to pick one celebrity and match that star head to head to collect that $5,000. Choose a celebrity now.
Betty White.
Oh, no, Jeff, please.
That's how you feel.
Thank you.
He chooses
I think my
Betty
plane
White.
Is...
No, well, now, wait a minute, Betty. He chose you. You get ready to write, and you turn around and face me, Jeff. I will get the question, which is right here. All right, Betty White, you write down your answer to this. Sour blank. Sour blank. Okay, she has finished, Jeff. Now, we call for your response to this fill-in. How do you do it? Sour?
Sour cream.
Sour cream. All right, Betty, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
We just went with a different bunch. Sour grapes.
Oh, sorry, Jeff.
I'm so sorry, Jeff.
I am sorry, Jeff, that you didn't win the $5,000. You've got $600, which is your to your credit. And in a moment or so, you're going to meet another player. But right now, let's pause for this. We are going to start another game, and what better way to begin than to introduce a new challenger. Here is Tony Sams. You wish each other well?
Oh, yes.
All right. They've said good luck to one another. That's a very sporting thing to do. Tony, who are you and where are you from and all that?
I'm from Gardena. I'm married 6 years and I have 2 children, and I enjoy all kinds of sports, especially water skiing.
Well, that's great. Good luck to you here. It's a pleasure to have you with us.
Thank you.
All right. Now, Tony, for your benefit, just briefly, both of you will be answering questions and trying to match our 6 celebrities. You'll get 2 chances. The one who's done that most often at the end of the second round will be the winner, gets $100, and the opportunity to go for $5,000, as Jeff did just a few moments ago. You saw him do that. All right. He's our current champ. Now, the challenger will make the first selection. So, Tony, you please pick.
I'll go along with B.
You'll go along with B.
Mm-hmm.
All right, celebrities, this is a new game, so each and every one of you will participate in this. Johnny, his mother screamed. Who ever heard of a blank for a pet? Johnny, his mother screamed. Who ever heard of a blank for a pet?
Ha.
Well done.
Fast.
Yep. Finally got the hang of it. Who ever heard of a blank for a pet? All right. Now, Tony, we get your response now. Who ever heard of a...
The only thing that sounds outrageous to me is a zebra.
Some of my best friends are zebras.
That is Tony Sam's answer, a zebra. Now, let's come
That's
over here.
That's gonna be a toughie, Gene.
Now, wait. Just wait and see how many times it happens up here. Wait. All right, Bert Convy, who ever heard of a...
Of a striped frog, as was a... Almost like
frog.
A zebra, I'm
frog
sorry.
For a pet. Okay, no match there, JP.
Well, how about...
Zebra's what we're looking for.
How about a zebra snake?
A snake for a pet. Okay.
What are you doing after the show, baby?
Yeah, snake.
Snake
you match
again?
JP. All right, no match up there. Tony Sams is looking for the word zebra, Brett.
Oh, would that I could give it to her. Lion.
Lion
oh.
is another outrageous pet. Okay, Richard Dawson.
You know, some of those snakes don't even have a pit to hiss in. I wrote alligator.
Alligator.
It's a very good diction.
Yes.
A pair of shoes to go, bless you.
Betty, what do you say? His answer is zebra. What's yours?
It's your reading, Gene. You made it so you really overacted is what you did. I said spider.
Spider. Okay, so there was no match there, and now we'll go to Jeff Nichols' side of this round. Are you ready, Jeff?
Ready.
Everybody plays?
Yes.
Pass.
John said to Jack, keep your hands off my blank. John said to Jack, keep your hands off my blank. Oh. Ready? Bert is deep in thought.
No, I'm desperately trying to clean it up is what I'm doing.
Trust your first instinct, Bert.
Well, I can't write it. I trust it, but I can't write it.
Now, Jeff, you give us your response. John said to Jack, keep your hands off my blank.
My wife.
My wife is what he says. All right, wife is his answer. What do you say, Bert?
I said the same. Keep your hands off my wife.
Wife is one match for you, Jeff. All right, JP.
I said, keep your hands off my gun.
My gun.
Watch your hands.
All right. All right, no wife there. Charles?
I say, keep your hands off my girl.
Can't match that, because wife and girl could be two different things. All right.
Actually, the question read, Jack said to John, keep your hands off my wife.
Whatever it is, wife is your answer, and wife was his answer, and that matches. And Richard.
And John said, why? Is she loaded? So I put wife.
Wife! Another match. You're doing pretty well with that, Jeff. Betty?
He said, keep your hands off my wife, and vice versa.
Okay. So you picked up four on that, Jeff. You're doing very well. And now as we go to round two, I must remind Tony Sams that she must match four celebrities to stay in the game. All right, Tony, make your selection.
I'll try A this time.
A is what she's going to try this time. Here we go. Final round. Mary never wears blank. Mary never wears blank. Must match four celebrities to stay in the running.
Somebody wrote something funny on a piece of my wallet.
Oh, I see.
Cards.
Okay. But you're finished. Lower tier is ready. Upper tier, you're slow. Okay, they're all ready. Now, Tony, Mary never wears
undies.
Undies is her answer.
Did she say undies?
She said undies.
Got it. It'll be a cold day in March before.
All right. Mary never wears undies is her
answer.
You're
the wrong generation for it, Betty.
Four celebrity matches to stay in the game, Tony. And let's begin with Bert Convy.
I said Mary never wears underwear.
Oh. Undies and underwear is a match.
Absolutely.
All right, you got one. You need three more. Let's go to JP.
You know how popular Mary is.
I hadn't thought of that, JP.
She doesn't wear bra or panties.
What does that mean? Bra and panties consist of undies? You won't match that. Okay.
Mary would have.
All right. No, I don't know why, but the judge says no, and that's the supreme authority.
Show us his underwear.
Show us his underwear? No, we can't do that. Charles, what do you say?
Well, Mary, as it's common knowledge, she doesn't wear underwear. She also doesn't wear makeup. And if you see her without her underwear and her makeup, believe me, you won't believe it.
All right, now, you must match the remaining celebrities down on this lower tier to stay in the game. Undies is her answer. Brett, what's yours?
Well, I try to always draw on my own personal life for these answers. I feel it helps. Girdle?
A girdle.
Does that fall into anything?
That is not a match, so Jeff Nichols wins again. Congratulations. I have $100 for you, Jeff. You're doing very well. We ought to say goodbye to Tony here, and we thank her for being with us. We've got a gift for you backstage. Tony, it was
thank
a pleasure
you.
Meeting you on Match Game 73. We'll be back to you and to Jeff Nichols right after this. Jeff Nichols is here for the second time to have another go at the Super Match. Are you ready, Jeff?
Ready.
Okay, let's get right to it. We polled a previous studio audience to get their best response to this. Captain Blank. Captain Blank. And you know how those responses go, $500, $250, and $100. And the celebrities are going to help you. Remember, what you win here is yours to keep, and then you try for 10 times the amount, just as last time. So now let's pick three celebrities, if you will.
Charles Nelson Reilly.
Well, there's three big guys, but how about Captain Midnight?
Yes, sir.
Captain Midnight is his response.
That's a good one.
One more, Jeff.
Brett.
How about Captain Bly?
Captain Bly. All right, and one to go now.
Bert.
Bert Convy.
Bert Convy.
Ooh, Jeff, that's toughy.
Captain Blank.
I was going to say Captain of Industry. Is that too obscure, do you think?
Yeah. Yes, we do.
How about Captain Marvel? That's what came to mind first for me.
But you said
Captain Marvel? Yeah. Is that your response?
Yes, that's
okay, that's it. So the celebrities have given you Captain Midnight, Captain Bly, and Captain Marvel. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own if you wish, Jeff. What do you wish to do?
I'll go with Brett. Captain Bly.
Oh. Captain Bly it is.
I'm sending up a prayer.
All right, we're looking for Captain Bly. May we see the $100 response? Captain Hook. Good one. Not there. All right, looking for Captain Bly. May we see the $250 response? Captain Kidd. Not there either. I see, that's another good one. Here is your last chance, Jeff. May we see the $500 response? Captain Kangaroo. So we had Hook, Kid, and Kangaroo, and none of us thought of those. I guess those are pretty good answers now that I see them. Well, Jeff, you've got the $700 you have won in the previous games, and more important than that, you have the right to meet another challenger. And let's meet that challenger now. Here is Joan DeYoung. Okay. Joan, Jeff Nichols there. Joan DeYoung, nice to have you with us. Would you like to say a word or two on your own behalf?
I work in publicity for a production company, and I'm a mother of two beautiful boys, Scott and Stephen.
I bet they are beautiful, because you're a very attractive lady yourself.
Thank you.
You know how to play this game?
I sure do.
Okay, good luck to both of you. Let's begin with round one. And Joan, you'll make the first selection.
I'll take A.
A is what she wants. We've got a brand new game here, celebrities. Everybody plays, and this is it. Mary had a cold blank. Mary had a cold blank.
I've got a cold head with that question.
A cold?
Having a little trouble there, Charles.
Well,
Mary had a cold blank. All right, we're all set now, and let's call on Joan DeYoung and get her response. Mary had a cold.
Since I have one, a cold in my nose. Cold in her nose.
Mary had a cold in her nose. Have you got a cold right now?
I sure do.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Okay, that's her answer. Mary had a cold in her nose. Bert, may we see your answer?
Slightly. I have a cold. I said nose.
Cold? Mary had a. No match.
No match.
Mary had a cold nose is your answer. Hers is Mary had a cold in her nose.
Two different
meanings there. Okay, JP.
Well, you remember that Mary is the one who didn't wear any underwear, panties?
Yeah.
She did have a cold nose.
She had a cold nose.
Yes.
Okay.
That's one of the assets of not wearing any underwear.
Right. And Charles, we're looking for... A cold in
Well,
Mary's
I just came
nose.
Back from the East, and Mary had a cold car.
Mary had a cold car. No match there. And let's check Brett Summers' answer. Mary had a cold...
My Mary was a dog, and she had a cold nose.
Cold nose. Okay, and Richard Dawson.
Well, Mary actually worked at an ice crushing plant. Backed into it and got a little behind in her work, I'm sorry to say.
Mary, Mary had a cold behind is what you say. Okay.
Well, let's give her a big hand anyway.
All right, Betty White. Mary had a cold in her nose is her answer. May we see yours?
If you think I'm going to give you a hand on that, you're crazy. She had a cold lunch.
Mary had
you
a cold lunch.
Up sometime.
Okay, so Joan, you did not score with that. Let's see how Jeff Nichols does with this.
I'm
Everybody
sorry.
Plays.
Ah.
Mary. Mary never told anyone her blanks were fake.
Oh, my.
That's what it
I
says.
I wouldn't touch that
right
with
here.
A barge pole.
Says that right here. Mary never told anyone her blanks were fake.
Well, if she says nothing, I'll say nothing.
All right, we're getting close to the end, so do it as quickly as you can.
All right.
I'm shitting the power at the celebrities. Okay, Jeff Nichols, we call for your response.
Her bus.
Her bust was, okay, that's his answer. Bert?
Oh, I was a little more graphic than that. I said her boobs.
Uh-oh. Well, there's one. JP?
Not to be out graphiced, I also said boobies.
Boobies, okay. All right, Charles.
I know her very well, and they're not that fake. It's her diamonds that need
her
looking
at. Her diamonds are fake. Okay. What do you say, Brett?
I try to lend a little class and respectability to this show. I said eyelashes.
All right. Richard Dawson?
I, too, said eyelashes, but she wears them just about here.
What do you say, Betty? Fake bust is what we're looking for.
She had hair on her chest. I said bosoms.
Bosoms. So there's another match for you. Score 3 times. We'll come back to our two players here right after this. Dear friends, that ends today's session of Match Game 73. We'll look forward to seeing both of you next time. We will finish this game in which our current champ is ahead 3-0. You were absolutely splendiferous.
Thank you, and you were
thank
too,
you
sir.
All. Now, next time we meet, we'll be back with this galaxy of stars.
Dick Gauthier, Barbara Stewart, Jack Carter, Joanne Flood, Richard Dawson, Shelley Winter.
So until next time, Gene Rayburn saying so long for Match Game 73.
Today's consolation prizes are a timely gift from WestClock. 70 Jewel Roman Sport Ladies Wristwatch in Boston Gold Color. High fashion from WestClock's Italian Industries Company. And a supply of delicious fill and eat Ready Crust. Your dessert will seem like it came from the pastry chef. Ready Crust, a special treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 73. A Mark Goodson built.